Hey there, how are you doing? This is Khalif from TechFanciers. So this is the moment that we all been waiting for. So in this video, we will see how to install the latest Android 13 custom ROM on Redmi Note 10 Pro or Pro Max. The code name is Sweet India or Sweet. So without wasting much time, we will get, let's get started this one. So shall we? So to get this things started, there are few requirements which we have already completed. If you have watched the previous video, you would have already know it. You first need to unlock the bootloader, which takes 7 days approximately. So once you unlocked it, you need a custom recovery, which also we have done it. So these are major two requirements that you need. And then you need to download the custom ROM for your device. You can pretty much Google it in your anywhere for custom ROM for Sweet or something. But I'm currently in part of the Redmi Note 10 community. So there in the channel, we have a lot of updates regarding that. The latest one as of now when I'm recording, it is 1080 OS. So, but I'm not going to install it. I just thought of installing this Project Elixir, but I finally decided to go with Rise Droid because I never tried the Rise Droid, and we also have the customization inside this one. So I have personalization and the other stuff. So due to that reason, I have thought of installing it. I never tried it. So this Rise Droid is also there for Note 11. So I have downloaded GMS version, which will have the G apps built in. So support, we have the different group. So G apps variant contains bit G apps by this Hitman. And OTA will work from next update. So this update won't work the OTA update, even though it is an official. It's Android 13 build, so don't expect the same stability as Android 12. So for this, just a video purpose only, we are installing the Android 13. So if you want to use a stability or you want to use it for long run, better go with the 12.1 or 12L. We also have Pixel experience, but this is beta. And so I already have downloaded the Rise Droid. I have it with me in the Android development and Note 10 Pro custom ROM. Here I have the Android, this one Rise Droid. Also, as we seen in our earlier video, we are going to use the Orange Fox recovery. So I'll keep the recovery also in the same folder, so it will be easy to copy all the things in one go. Once you, as soon as you install the custom ROM, you may need to install the Orange Fox recovery to get installed other stuffs. But if you install it, you may not able to use the OTA update when they have pushed through their stream. So you no need a recovery, but if you want the recovery, you better install it right after the Rise Droid. If you want to use it for long run or something, you may need the Rise Droid's official own recovery. So it will be a part of the ROM, I think. So here you have it. You may need to manually flash this or something. So yeah, that's good to know. So now I have already have everything in the USB cable. I'll just connect to the device. Also, I have it is last time itself we have enabled the USB debugging, but due to this security, that video, we have to disable it. So now I am going back again and additional settings, developer option, and I can just now enable the USB debugging. So yeah, I'm aware. So we'll wait for 10 seconds. So in that time, in my PC, I'll go to ADB fast boot tool, and here I have the command here option. If I open, it will open this one, and here I will allow. And now if I type ADB devices, you can see that device is attached now. Okay, so now I will reboot to recovery. ADB reboot recovery. So in the same time, we are having this custom ROM. So I am going to use the ADB side load method, because that is more easier than that. We also have other methods. If you want to know, you can visit the Redmi Note 11 series. In upcoming videos, when I install different custom ROM, I will try to do it in different ways. So here I have it. So where I need to go to enable ADB debugging, ADB side load. So here I have the ADB side load. Before doing that, I have to check which partition I am right now. So is it having a two partition? I have no idea, so I need to check that one. I believe this one has only one slot, or I think so, because we are currently in MIUA, right? So I also, before proceeding with this, make sure you have all the backup of your all your data. So that is important. So I will go wipe and format the data. So I will type yes and format the data. Okay, now I will select device data, this one, internal, this one, micro SD, and this one you don't need to select. Okay, I have selected this five and I can wipe this one. So once it is wiped, I will just reboot to the recovery again, so that it will get updated properly. Also, you will be able to see that storage in your laptop. So now we have installed this one. So the storage also now visible. I will go here and I'll select I'll now go to ADB side load and I will start the side load process. So as it is side load started in my PC, I'll type ADB devices. So it will show the device is now connected through ADB side load. So now I type ADB side load and then I can just drag and drop the rice droid and hit enter. So here the device started updating the things. It will take some time, so please be patient. Also, in my Redmi Note 11, it will go till only 49% to 50%. After that, it will show extra something, and then it will get finished. So we'll see, same is happening here also. Also, if I'm not installing this recovery, I may not able to access the storage in future if I want to install Magisk or something. So I better install the custom recovery also in this build, and we will try whether the decryption is properly working or not. Yeah, here XFR it's shown only 49%, so which means it is all now installed. So I will go back and I'll select wipe Dalvik cache. I will wipe. I think I can use some other option. So here I will go again and open the ADB side load, and I do this both things. So now this time I'm going to side load the Orange Fox recovery. So ADB side load, and then I'm going to drag and drop the Orange Fox recovery. So if you want to receive official OTA updates, you better don't use this method right after installing this one. If you don't want, or you are doing it for some other purpose or something, you can directly go ahead and install this. Also, I believe that Orange Fox also supports OTA update. There is one option, we are able to see that. So yeah. Okay, now we have logged in back to this one, and the storage is and here we have the Fox folder, and in my laptop also the storage got detected. So I will just now try to reboot to the recovery, so we can understand whether it is properly installed or not. Now we don't need a PC also, so I will just remove it. And yeah, we are booting in this one. So now we will boot to the system and it should work. I'm not sure whether this one doesn't have a two partition or not. I don't know, because my Note 11 has two partition, two slots. This one also should have, but yeah, we'll see that. Okay, it is directly booting to Rise Drive, so which means it doesn't have two partition or something. Maybe if it shows in only TWRP or something, I don't know, but. So now it is booted. We will change the setup side and enter this one. I'm not going to do full FRP and all, so I'm going to set it up offline. And yeah. Okay, so we are currently in Rise Drive. I like this icon design, refreshed look, and it feels actually good, to be honest. And I'll open the setting and about phone. Here we have the Rise Drive, official Rise Drive. It is a lineage based one, I think, so that is there. And I have the Android version 13. Tiramisu and ice cream 6.0, sweet. Those are the kernel, is sleepy kernel 4.14. And yeah, it is September 5th security patch. We are yet to reach the 5th October, so that is there. Devices officially supported, built with love with Jim Say. Thank you for the making this one. Let me check the camera. So what camera it has? So we have a normal camera and the Google Cam. So Google camera while using it. Okay. So this is the same camera which we were having it in the Note 11. So, and yeah, which gives normal functionalities and things. You also have a HDR option, I think. Okay, it's not there. Okay, so that is not fine. That's fine. And here you have the open AOSP camera, and here come back, and we'll also try whether the voltage is working or not. 198. Yeah, voltage is working fine. And then customization wise, what is there? Personalization. So themes, icon, kitchen. Okay, so here we have a few customization, higher FPS, unlimited photos, blur, this thing, that thing, and network monitor indicator, and data usage summary. Where is network monitor indicator? Here we have the network monitor indicator. Okay, good. So we have pretty much most of the this one, and we don't have the under display fingerprint, but it is showing. It is our, this one is the fingerprint. So yeah, that is pretty much good about this one. It looks fine for me. And so yeah, so that's what about installing this custom ROM. We have now successfully installed it. So the path is almost over now. Just there's only one content which will somewhat fulfills the process of doing this series. So yeah, thank you for watching. Code Metal.